What's up guys, welcome back to another Call of Duty Black Ops Cold War video. In today's video we're going to be talking about the PC version of Black Ops Cold War. So we got some new information today about the PC version, about what launcher it's going to be on, and also the developer behind the PC version of Black Ops Cold War. So Activision has sent out a bunch of emails to promote the reveal that's going to be happening within Warzone on August 26th for Black Ops Cold War. That's when we're going to be getting the worldwide reveal. That's when we're getting like the reveal trailer. Pre-orders are going to go live, as well as like a bunch of other news, I'm sure, and tons of other stuff will be happening that day as well. But they sent out emails, and in the emails, they actually say, they showed off this image, says Activision Call of Duty Black Ops Cold War, PC exclusively on Blizzard Battle.net, worldwide reveal August 26th. So this confirms that the PC version of Black Ops Cold War will not be on Steam. It won't be on like the Windows Store. It won't be on the Epic Game Store. It's going to be on Battle.net. That's going to be it. So this isn't really too much of a surprise, other than the fact that I've seen a bunch of people in the community that are mad about this. I mean, like, this has been the case for the last 2 years. Black Ops 4 was the first game exclusively on Battle.net. Then Modern Warfare was as well. So, like, why would they enter that tradition now with Black Ops Cold War? It's still going to be on Battle.net. It's Activision's own launcher. I mean, they own Blizzard. Activision Blizzard, they own Battle.net. So that's where it's going to be. They get a higher cut of all the revenue rather than, say, Steam or the Epic Game Store or something like that. So, not really a surprise there. Plus, I feel like if they did release it also like on Steam, I'm not sure exactly how that would work. Maybe, like, would that mean the player pool would be split? So you'd have, like, PC users who are on Steam and PC users who are on Battle.net? Or could they combine them? I don't know. I think it's just easiest for Activision to do it all on Blizzard. Plus, like I said, it's their own launcher. So, I mean, it's pretty standard. I don't think anyone was really assuming it was going to change this year, but apparently some people are still mad about that. And then we also have information on the developer for this year's game. So also in the email, it says that Black Ops Cold War is developed by Treyarch and Raven, which you already knew that. Treyarch and Raven are the ones who are both like co-developing this year's game. They're working together for this year's game. But there's also Beenox, and it's published by Activision with Blizzard Entertainment. So Beenox is going to be developing a PC version of this year's Call of Duty game. Now, I believe Beenox also worked on the PC version of Black Ops 4. As well as I'm pretty sure they did the PC version for Modern Warfare. Now, I could be wrong about Modern Warfare, but I'm pretty sure they at least did Black Ops 4. So, I mean, they did, like, a pretty decent job. Like, Modern Warfare on PC is honestly, like, genuinely, like, pretty good. It's also been really good with, like, crossplay and stuff. I mean, PC definitely has an advantage, but, like, it's been a pretty good port, and it hasn't been, like, a bad port. You see a lot of, like, people on Twitch and here on YouTube who play this game on PC. And I think it's a good thing. I mean, like, Beenox has been doing a pretty good job, but I think the main issue that comes with having a different developer doing specifically for the PC version is that they basically have to get all this stuff from Treyarch and from Raven. They're gonna be like, okay, what do you guys want fixed? What is the patch going out on Xbox and on PlayStation? How do we adjust that for PC? Because it started with Black Ops 4. Black Ops 4 was really the first game that we started getting kind of PC exclusive updates. So it was like certain things behave differently on PC, like depending on like the frame rate and different things. So they started actually changing things around specifically for the PC version, starting with like Black Ops 4. They'd put out weapon patches and make certain weapons better or worse on the PC version, so it wasn't completely identical to the, like, say, Xbox and PlayStation versions. Those ones are identical to each other, but the PC version was ever so slightly different, and that's just because they have a separate developer working on that, and they need to adjust it specifically for that platform, because PC, a lot of things can change when you're on PC compared to a console, so they got to make sure that each weapon performs like it should and is not overpowered, or every weapon's balanced like it should be when it, you know, you're on PC. But the point I'm driving at is that it kind of sucks though having a different developer, because they have to take all that input from Treyarch and Raven and then has to go through Beenox rather than Treyarch and Raven just doing it themselves right there and just putting out a PC update. They kind of have to relay this information to Beenox, and Beenox has to make the update for PC. So there's just a little bit of a delay. Like, that's kind of what happened a little bit with Black Ops 4. Sometimes we got like delayed updates on PC where like we'd get an update on Xbox and PS4 like the exact same day, and then we'd have to wait like a day or two, or I think it was like up to a week at some point for some PC updates, and that's just because it's a totally different developer. So I don't know, I mean, that's just the information we have right now about the PC version, and I'm sure it's going to perform just like Modern Warfare. I mean, it's apparently going to be using like the same engine and stuff, so hopefully it'll be a little bit better. Also, hopefully with the PC version this year, they'll actually allow us to only install sections of the game that we want, because you can do that on console. You can install just the campaign or just multiplayer, just Warzone or something like that, but on PC, you literally had to have it all for some reason, which is super dumb. And Modern Warfare is sitting well over 200 gigabytes right now, and it's honestly just really ridiculous. So hopefully file sizes are lower on PC and just in general, but also hopefully they will allow us to have separate downloads for all these different modes and stuff, and basically allow us to download whatever we want to play in the game on PC as well. But that's going to do it for our video today, guys. As we get more information about the PC version, about Black Ops Cold War in general, I'll make sure to let you guys know. So make sure you guys ring that notification bell when you subscribe to the channel, that you guys don't miss out on any new Black Ops Cold War videos. Thank you all so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.